Becky, as a grain bin safety advocate,
harvest time is the most exciting and also the most exhausting and scary time of the year for any farmer. Everything a farmer has worked towards all year comes down to this time. Will the harvest be good? Will it be bad? And just what can go wrong? Because something always does go wrong. Now the harvest of 2020 is done and dusted, so we can find out the answers to that. Farmers on YouTube have kept us updated on how their harvests have gone. Today, we are going to look at what happened with one of our favorite farmers. Let's see a harvest 2020 Millennial Farmer Recap. Before we get into the video, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss anything we post. First thing, let's remind everyone who the Millennial Farmer is. One of the most popular farmers on YouTube, Zach Johnson, started the channel with his wife, Becky, to give people a better idea of where their food comes from and how to help work against misinformation that gets spread on social media. With his dad, he farms on a farm in Minnesota, and they grow corn and soybeans. The first day of harvest came pretty unexpectedly. Zach was just telling viewers that he didn't think that they would be starting the harvest yet. Then his father came in to tell him that some of the soybeans were ready. So we know a farmer is at the mercy of nature. When the crops are ready, the harvest starts. They had to start getting everything ready very quickly. They had to set up the combiner and make sure that all the machines were greased properly. It was interesting to see that this was the scariest moment of the year for Zach. The combiner doesn't work for about 10 months in between harvests. So when he starts it up again, there is always a possibility that something has gotten into the rotors. Luckily, this was not the case when they could get started. But this didn't mean that the first day was without its share of troubles. Some of the first day troubles they had. They had just bought a new tractor and it didn't want to start. They started on a soybean field. It was really cool to see what they harvested and just how it looks going into the combine and then into the grain cart. But the first field was not great quality. They had to adjust the combiner to pick up most of the beans. The field had dried too much and the soybeans were small. Zach's dad had some trouble with his leg too. He had just had a knee replacement, so was still keeping his leg relatively inactive. He took breaks and made sure to rest, but one time, while climbing on the steps of the combine, he hurt his leg. It was swollen, and for the next few days, he tried to take care of it and get the swelling down while still working and helping with the harvesting. In later videos, he had to see the doctor again and eventually had another round under the knife. He had torn some stitches at the back of his knee and had to have them fixed. When the doctor opened up the injury, it was worse than they thought. Then, Zach's dad had to wear a brace. While he was still an amazing help throughout the harvest, he wasn't able to do as much as he normally would. Luckily, they had another little helping hand to take the wheels. Onyx Johnson, the Millennial Farmer's son, helped with the harvest. One of the stars to come out of this harvest was Onyx, who got a chance to get behind the wheel and help with the harvest. He was allowed to drive the grain cart, and after getting some instructions, he was allowed to handle it solo. I was a bit surprised that he was allowed anywhere near the machine. Not because he couldn't handle it, but because he was wearing another YouTuber's hat. He had a hat on from Welker Farms. They quickly noticed and commented. All in good fun, I'm sure. Let me tell you, that kid worked. He got home from school and hockey practice and then came right out to help his dad. Together, they harvested a lot of fields. His parents were super proud of him. The viewers that have seen him grow before our eyes felt like proud parents too. He is only 10 years old, but he was very reliable and worked into the night along with all the adults around him. He's already a great little farmer. But they don't say that harvest is an extremely difficult time for no reason. Getting the harvest started takes a lot of moving parts. Many things have to be prepared and ready for the harvest to come in. They have to get the bins ready to receive all the new produce, and they seem to be pretty stubborn. Throughout the harvest, they had many different problems with the grain bins. Many of the problems called for Zach to actually go into the bins to fix the problem. This can be very dangerous, as many farmers are lost each year from accidents that happen inside the bins. Zach and Becky decided that during the harvest time, they would donate $5,000 to causes that work on bin safety. Their viewers quickly started contributing too, and this was a cause that they ran during the entire time of the harvest. The soybean harvest took a while. It seems that even a small amount of rain is enough to make it impossible to harvest the beans. So every time it started to rain, they had to stop. This gave them enough time to clean up things like the corn sewage. Not a very glamorous part of farming, but still necessary. After some more problems and holdups, they at last finished the soybean harvest. That is when the corn harvest started. It seemed like all the corn in the neighborhood was already about the same time. Suddenly, all the neighbors all around the farm were busy harvesting too. Normally, we all think of a farm as a quiet place, but this all changes during harvest. There are the noises of the tractors and combines, then the big noise maker is the corn dryer. It dries the corn before it gets stored. The farm also becomes a lot less neat during the harvest. There's dust everywhere, they don't have as much time to clean up constantly. Harvesting is a dusty time anyway. Even the Johnsons' little girls grabbed shovels and started shoveling dirt around the house. This family really worked together to get the harvest in. Mrs. Millennial Farmer was helping working with the kids, bringing food and even editing the videos too. Another added stress was that a lot of things broke. Everything from machines to electric wires and to the fans on the bins was breaking. Zach's youngest daughter even broke her arm. But besides the arm, they luckily had someone that seemed to be able to fix everything. Jim. He was worth his weight in gold, fixing things as far as he went. So with Jim's help, they could keep going with the harvest, even when things were very frustrating. Still, there were some stunning parts to the harvest. It wasn't all just dust and broken machines. There were some very nice moments to the harvest, too. Beautiful sunsets, awesome views from some of the fields, and an amazing harvest moon were just some of the special scenes from the Millennial Farmer's harvest. He also got to play with some new toys. Some of the big tractor companies allow farmers to use their machines to test them out, so they were allowed to use the new John Deere X9 Combiner. It is really a machine that is made for huge farms where they have multiple tractors and want to combine it all into one machine so they need less labor. There was a lot that they liked about it and some things that they didn't. But that wasn't the only surprise that was waiting for his viewers. He asked a friend to come with his tractor. When he showed up, it was Nick Welker from Welker Farms, but that wasn't the biggest surprise. Normally, you only see green machines on the Millennial Farm, but this time it was a red Case IH 620 quad track that he was also allowed to use. Again, there were things he liked and some that he didn't. If you are interested in knowing what he thought, check out his videos about the pros and cons of both machines. The harvest moved along quickly. They started on the harvest about a week before they normally would. The corn harvest was especially going very well and giving better yields than normal. But a farmer is dependent on nature to get his work done, and sometimes nature just likes to mess with you. The weather was very weird for that time of year. It was very cold, and almost 3 weeks before they wanted it, the snow started to fall. Now, apparently they are able to keep harvesting if the snow is very frozen, but when it's sticky, it is impossible. Then it goes into the machine and blocks everything up. So they had to put a pause on the harvest. Luckily, there's always more work on a farm, so they didn't get any rest during that time. They started to tillage the parts that they were going to plant in spring. At last, they felt that it was time to get back to the harvest. That was until a little more snow fell. Are you seeing a pattern here? With just 100 acres left, they just couldn't get it all finished. It was frustrating, but gave them time to make sure that they had enough space to put the last bit of produce that still needed to get stored. After a lot of waiting and frustration, at long last, they were able to finish off the last bit of harvest for 2020. It had moments of frustration and moments of fun. There were proud moments with Onyx starting his journey as a young farmer and moments of fun with the dogs providing entertainment. Like on any farm, that didn't mean that the work was done. There is always more work. The fields still needed to be fertilized and the tillage needed to be finished. But all in all, the harvest was a success for the Millennial Farmer. I hope you enjoyed this recap of his harvest 2020. Until next time.